हेलो गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रेन, हाउ आर यू? एम आई ऑडिबल? कैन यू लिसन मी? प्लीज रिस्पॉन्स. ओके, सो आफ्टर ए लॉन्ग टाइम वी आर हियर टू डिस्कस द न्यू लेसन, दैट इज द लेसन नंबर 12, स्मार्ट चार्ट. ओके एंड चिल्ड्रेन, आई हैव सीन योर परफॉर्मेंस इन एमसीक्यू टेस्ट. आई थिंक इट इज नॉट अप टू द मार्क. आई हैव सीन दैट मेनी चिल्ड्रेन आर गेटिंग वेरी लेस मार्क्स. व्हाट वाज द प्रॉब्लम? कैन यू टेल मी व्हाट वाज द प्रॉब्लम? यस, व्हाई डिडंट यू आंसर करेक्टली? Very few children got 40 out of 40 and many are getting above 35. Many are getting less than 30 and 25. Even they are getting 10, 12 marks. What is the problem? I think that there was no problem in the question paper and all the things you have done in the live classes. It means you are not revising. Those children who are revising, who are studying well, they are getting good marks, excellent marks. And those who are not revising, they are not attending the class, they are not getting good marks. So children, it is very, very important. You must have to attend the class. You must have to revise. You must have to see the video again and again. You have to make the practice, written practice. If you are not doing, it is not so easy that without revising, without making practice, you can get good marks in your mathematics. It is not like the other subject that one day you learn all the lessons, you mug up it and you will get the marks. It is not like the other subject. This is maths. If you have practiced well, if you have done well, again and again you are doing practice, then only you can get the good marks. Okay? So, it is my request to all of you that make your practice, written practice, do at home in your rough notebook or any notebook. Whatever the question was there, you should revise it, you should do it. If you are not doing, then you will not get more good marks. And one more thing, children, this is the final call for you. If you are not writing your roll number, then I will not put your attendance. And you have seen that daily attendance is going on your WhatsApp group. So, by the name, I will not put your attendance. I will make you absent and I will send your name in absentees. You must have to write your roll number. Without roll number, I will not mark your presence there. Okay? So, you must have to make your presence and I can see that out of 97 children, only 40 children are watching. They are present in the class. Out of 97, you can see that only 40 children are there. Then, how can those children suppose that they will get good marks in their exam if they are not attending the class? So, it is the fault of the children, those who are not attending the class, and the fault of the parents also at the same time. Because the parents has to make the arrangement, they have to see whether their wards are doing the class or not. Okay? So just I am in your presence. If your name is there on your WhatsApp group, it means you are absent. If your name is not there, it means you are present. If after sending the message, after sending your name list, If you are thinking that you are present there in the class and your name is written there, then you can talk to the teacher. But at the same time, the teacher will say that you see the live chat. If your roll number is present in your live chat, then only he or she will mark the presence there. Okay? So this is the thing, sir. Now, that one MCQ for the four lessons is over, and I am very disappointed, and madam will be also very disappointed by looking these marks, sir. So I am requesting you, all children, and your parents also, please take care, please, please make practice for the mathematics, sir. Okay? Now, we have to start the smart chart. Actually, here, lesson number 12, smart chart, part 1. Children, you are doing this smart chart from, I think, class 2nd or 3rd. I think in class 2nd also, there was some question, the last chapter. Smart chart was there in third lesson, third class also, in fourth class also. Now this is in fifth class. Can you tell me this smart chart is related to what chapter? That whenever, but there is a branch of mathematics in which this chapter will come. That is called statistics. That is called statistics, and in your further class you will not get the name by smart chart, you will get the name by the data handling. Data handling. So this lesson is related to data handling. It means we have to handle some data here. So here the collection of the data is required here. We have to gather that information from our surroundings. What is happening in our surroundings, that we are handling that data, we are collecting the information, we are making the data, and then when we summarize it, then it is called smart chart, or in other words, we can say it is the data handling. Okay? So, this lesson is related to this one. Whenever we are collecting the information, there is a lot of information is there. Sometimes the informations are in random way, and sometimes it is in organized way. So, if the data is in random way, then it is very difficult to find out the result, find out the answer of some question related to that data. But when we organize it, when we arrange in proper manner, proper way, then it becomes very easy to handle it. It is very easy to answer the questions which are related to that data. Okay? For example, if we are collecting the data of the age of the different children in our class, then if we are writing the age in years and months, then different years and months will be there. Year may be same, but month will be different. Days will be different. So why, if we are writing randomly, then it is very difficult to find out that how many children are there who are of that particular age. Say 10 years, 5 months, 10 years, 2 months, 10 years, 1 month, like that one. In same way, if we are collecting the data about the weight of the children of our class, then we measure the weight of our class children, and we are writing the data in random way, then it is very difficult that how many children of are there with, who are at the particular weight. But if we are organizing in proper way, then it is very easy that how many children are there whose weight is 20 kilograms. So these are the data, and these data, when they are organized, then it is very easy to handle it, to give the proper answer. So handling of these data becomes very easy. So these things is done in this branch of mathematics that is called the later evil study, statistics, when you will go to higher class. But here up to secondary class you will learn, up to 8th class you will learn by a data handling. Here in our class we are discussing as a smart chart. Okay, so whenever different informations we are getting and we have to organize them, then there we are using a small line segment that is known as tally marks. Tally marks, we are using the tally marks so that we can organize, we can write here as what is tally mark. Tally mark, when we are drawing the small line segment, we are drawing, that is called tally mark. So we can write here the small line segment drawn in a group of five to show a data are called a tally mark. Tally mark, these are represented by like this, in this way. Four lines we are drawing the vertically and one line we are just drawing the diagonally by intersecting these lines. By crossing these lines we are drawing one line diagonally from this corner top to bottom. This is the group of five. So one, this one group shows the five. So this 1, 2, 3, 4, these four lines are there and this is the fifth line. Okay, in other way also we can just show like this. Like this also we can show. These four lines are there and one line there. So different way, in different way we can show it. In different way we can show. So these are the symbol for the tally marks. Okay, now other thing is there, pictograph. Pictograph, when we are showing any information by use of pictures, and symbols, these are called pictograph. When the data is represented by using symbols and pictures, then it is called a pictograph. So that we will write here the representation of a data using pictures and symbols, pictures or symbols is called a pictograph. Okay, in this pictograph we can just suppose there a data of a bulb sold on a shop in whole day, different watts of the bulbs are sold at a shop during the day. Then if we want to collect this data during the day, then we can represent by drawing the bulbs. In same way, different symbols we can use. Okay, so when we are using the symbols and pictures for to show the data, then that is called the, it is a to represent the data, then it is called the pictograph. Okay, now another thing is, what is data? What is data? What information we are collecting from our surroundings? The information gathered from our surroundings is called as data. And this data is in random way or organized way, in different way. Okay, so we can write the information informations collected from our surroundings is a called a data. This may be in organized way or random way. Okay, so this is the concept. It is just an introduction. We can say that I am just introducing of this lesson. Okay. Now on this basis of these informations, just we will solve some questions. We will write some questions. Some questions are given in textbook. On the basis of that, we will take some other question also and we will solve it. Okay. Now you are aware that all of you are very fond of keeping the pet. People keep the different types of the pet. Some like parrot, some like cat, some like dog, some like rabbit, and so on. Some people like mouse also. Right. So different that some people like to keep lovebird. So different pets are kept by the different people. They are favorite to them. So on the basis of this, we will do one question. So here question is, the favorite pets of different people is given below. Look at the table. Look at the table and answer the following. Okay, now I'm making the table here. Here, name of the pet, And here, one more column we will make. Here tally marks. And number of pets. Number of pets. Here we write dog. We are making some columns here. Okay. Dogs. A dog and a parrot. Cat and some other we can take rabbits. Rabbits and we can take some other. That is rats. Okay. Just I am making some tally marks here. These are the tally marks given here. And this question can be given, one more question can be added in this question. Complete the table. It may be written here, complete the table. Complete the table and answer the following question. Okay. So, if we have to complete it, then we have to fill up this part. This will be vacant. That will be empty, blank place will be there, we have to write these numbers. So, we can count in number of, in a groups, because these tally marks are given in a groups. And this, the children, this lesson is very, very easy chapter is there. Just you pay attention, then you can solve all the questions. There is no question which you cannot solve. Okay? So, just we will count here. Just we count the group, number of group, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, in one group, 5. So, 5 groups are there, then 5, 5, yeah, 25. And then, 2 more is there. Then, it means, here 27 dogs are there. Okay? Now, after this, we count this one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 groups are there. So, 5, 6, yeah, 30 plus 1. This is 31. Then it is 1, 2, 2 groups. So 5, 2 are 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. So we write here 14. Here 1, 2, 3 groups. So 5, 3 are 15, 16, 17, 18. So we write here 18. Now 1, 2, 3, 4. No group is there. So only 4 is there. Okay. So, just we have completed the table. We have completed the table. These were vacant, blank, and we have completed just. So, this is blank. Okay. Now, on this basis, we can just write some question. Which is the most, which is the most favorite pet? Now give the answer. Which is the most favorite pet? Yes, this is parrot. Why parrot? Why parrot is there? Why parrot is there? Why parrot is the most favorite pet? Yes. Why parrot is most favorite? Because it is the maximum number. Largest number is 31. Maximum number is there. So that is why this is the most favorite. Means the 31 people are there which like to keep parrot. 31 people are there who like to keep a parrot. So this is the most favorite. Okay? So we write here parrot. Now next question. Which is the least favorite pet? Which is the least favorite pet? Rat. Very good. Very good. Least favorite is rat because the rat is only 4, so very few people. A few people like to keep a parrot. So rat. So rat is the least favorite pet. Okay? Now C part. How many people like to keep a dogs and a cat together? How many people like to keep dog and cat together? How many people? Dog and cat together. Yes, very good. Bhushan. That 27 plus 14, that is equal to 41 people. Very good. Very good. So here we have to add the dogs 27 and cat 14. So just we add it and then we will get here 41. That is 27 plus 14 is equal to 41. So this 41 people. Okay. Now we can write some more question. Many question we can make. Many question. Okay. Many question we can make. D part. How many more people like parrot than rabbits? How many more people like parrot than rabbit? How many more people? What will you do? Now what will you do? Yes. 31 minus 18 is equal to 13. Very good. Very good. Yes, children. You are answering correctly. So here we write answer as a. This is. Parrots are 31 minus. Rabbits are 18, that is equal to 13 people. So children, in this way, we can write some more questions from this question. Okay? Now, we will write some new question. On the basis of your textbook question, I am taking the new question. So it means whatever questions are there in video that you have to practice, on the basis of that question, you can do the question which are given in your textbook. Okay? You can do in your textbook. Okay? Now, another question is, we write here, Roma sat on window of her room. She saw different vehicles passing on the road near by her house. Okay? Just look at the table and answer the questions. Answer the questions. Now table is here. Just you are taking table. Okay. Name of the vehicles and here number of the vehicles. Okay. Now car, bus, motorbike, tractor, and auto, rickshaw. Auto rickshaw. Okay? Here. In a day, here we can write. In a day. In a day. Whole day ka hum काउंट करेंगे इसमें. ओके, सो वी कैन राइट हियर इन अ डे. जस्ट आई कैन राइट वंस अगेन इफ इट इज नॉट क्लियर. इज इट क्लियर? ओके, जस्ट आई कैन राइट वंस अगेन हियर इन अ डे. लुक एट the table and okay, now it's okay. The whole day we are writing. So here car are 35, buses 12, and motorbike it is 49, and tractor 3, auto rickshaw 25. Okay, this is the table. On the basis of this table we have to answer the question. Okay, now we can write that question, which vehicle was passed on the road or just in another way we can write. Drive the vehicle past on that day. Okay, answer. Now second question, next question. Now you tell the answer. Write the vehicle which was in the most number passed on that day on the road. Okay? Which was that? Motorbike. Very good. Correct answer. Motorbike is there here. 49 is there. So we write here. Motorbike. Now how many more buses passed on the road than tractor on that day. That day. Answer. How many more buses passed on the road than tractor on that day? How many more? Yes, 12 minus 3, that is equal to 9. Very good. 12 minus 3 is equal to 9 buses. Okay. Now next question. Next question. we can write C part, how many vehicles were counted by Roma on that day? How many vehicles were counted by Roma on that day? What will we do, children? Yes. What will we do? How many vehicles were counted? Yes, very good. 35 plus 12 plus 3 plus 49 plus 25. Okay? So that all we will add. This 35 plus 12 plus 49 plus 3 plus 25. When we add it, then how much bill will you get? 5 plus 2 7 7 9 16 16 3 19 19 5 24 2 3 2 5 6 4 10 12 124. Yes, you have answered correctly, 124. Okay, now next question, D part we are taking, that how many more people, how many people like car and a motorbike, how many people like cars and a motorbike? Yes, what will we do? Who is this one? Rudransh Sharma, why do you want to finish the class? Abhi aaye aur abhi class khatam karni hai, kuch padhe likhe nahi, bas khali class khatam kar dena hai, kuch padhna likhna nahi. इतनी जल्दी तुम्हारे को क्लास में? सो यस, सम चिल्ड्रन आर, मेनी चिल्ड्रन आर आंसरिंग. रुद्रांश, यू आर नॉट आंसरिंग एनी क्वेश्चन, जस्ट यू आर ओनली जस्ट मेकिंग द फन हियर इन द क्लास. इफ क्लास इज कंटिन्यू, देन यू हैव टू बी प्रेजेंट देयर थ्रू आउट द क्लास. डोंट से व्हेन एवर टाइम इज ओवर आई विल फिनिश इट. Okay children, when you are answering very correctly, that is 35 plus 49. So here you can see that cars are 35 and motorbike is 49. So just we add 35 plus 49, that is equal to 95, 14 and 43, 71, 8, 84 people. So this is the question. In this way, we can make many more questions. And we can get the answer from this table only. On the basis of this table, we can answer and we can tell the answer of any question which is related to that one. Okay, children? So, any doubt to anybody? Any doubt to anybody here? If you have any doubt, then you can ask the question. And because the one question takes 10 to 15 minutes, because writing the question and answering, it is it will take much time, and time is not much. It is only 5 minutes, 4 minutes is left for the beginning to begin the another class. So another class, another teacher will take the class in this room. So we are bind up here. If you have any doubt, then you can put. But children, you have to make your practice. Okay. So bye bye and have a nice day. And many children, you are not submitting your class, your worksheet. Many children are not submitting. You submit it. Okay. You make it practice. Otherwise, for the annual examination, you will not do it properly. Okay.